Welcome to a game called Serena. I just saw it on Steam. It was free to put.
Right there. Maybe I could have another look.
As I was saying, I found this game on Steam, and I figured, why not play it? It's supposedly an indie horror game, so I've never played it, never seen it. I just saw it there, so I just want to play it. And
just one more try. I know it's pointless, but I need to do it.
Okay, if I could finish here, thank you. I guess we're just gonna go ahead and get started. This is my only source of light because I'm already scared. Oh, okay. She's blurred out. And yeah. Okay. What do we need to do here? Is it...
I still can't understand. Even the features of her face feel hazy and distant, like remnants of a broken dream.
Mm-hmm. Looks like the game has cut out, the music has cut out, so I really have no clue what to do. Do I move WASD? No, this is to look up, this is to look down. What do I do? Run.
Somewhere in here, in our private refuge, there must be something that reminds me of her.
There must be something that reminds me of her. What's this? Let's see. I'm scared.
I miss her so much. How is it possible that I can't remember her face?
Well, because it's blurred out. Now I'm guessing that you left her. Did she leave you? No. You said I miss her so much. I'm afraid of opening this.
Quite a large armoire for our admittedly Spartan needs. She uses most of it.
Was she trying to cast for the roll of 300? Okay.
For some reason, light bulbs wouldn't last long in this lamp. I never looked into it.
Okay. Oh. Okay, we've got blankets, we've got a Bible, so they must be a Christian family.
She adored all things of nature. I remember her long walks out in the woods. She is fairly religious, not me. I'm the cold and cynical bastard.
Wow.
But I don't remember that ever being an issue between us.
Well, that's good. Let's see. Can we close this? Here we go. A key.
Our refuge from the world. A place of warmth and passion.
That's where they make the love, right? What was that? I'm already afraid. Why am I so afraid? Okay. We've got a disturbing picture of two little girls and a supposedly anonymous girl. Okay.
No, I don't want to leave right now. There's still something for me in here.
Like what? A chair.
So many afternoons spent in this armchair.
Reading, studying, probably reading, yeah. Washington, Michael, Arthright. The things that keep us tired. Common sense and other lovely fairy tales. Nephilim, the greatest mystery of Amtadelirium world. Valhalla Strikes Back, the official hint book. Zombie space dinosaurs from the deep ate my family. What? The St. Christopher School lockdown. Okay,
so much wisdom and happiness in this bookcase. My life would have been much poorer without all this.
Because books seem to be interesting. Let's see what's under.
I should look around some more. I have to remember her face.
Okay. But where do I go? Okay.
The furniture came with the cabin. Considering how off the beaten path this place is, that helped make up our mind.
Supposedly, this man is supposedly looking for something that to help remember Serena's face. Serena is the wife. I thought it was like some sort of kid or something. I don't know what it is.
Sometimes she would brush her leg against mine under the table when we were eating. A curious, sensual thrill.
Oh, getting that love making.
You always put too much salt in, dear. Think about your pressure.
The table is worn but sturdy, just like our relationship was. Or is. I just don't know anymore.
Okay. Never knew anything. What else do I have to look at?
We had such a wonderful time dining in this cabin. Serena loved to experiment with her cooking.
The place looks so worn out now.
Sharing meals with a good red wine was one of the great pleasures in our relationship, especially in the intimacy of this cabin.
Can I look anywhere else? The chair.
This one wobbles. I always meant to do something about that, but somehow never got around to it.
What haven't I looked at?
Our dining table. Quite modest, but if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Oh, a picture. Okay, it looks like a deeper woods. This looks like a guy. There's a ghost here. I feel like I'm actually in this little cabin and just looking through. Oh gosh.
This window never got much attention. Then again, the view isn't nearly as spectacular. Priorities, right?
Right. Where else can I could look through here? Okay, oh, there's a chest. I'm scared of opening it.
Something draws me to this trunk. Is it the memories locked within? Or something else?
Oh, I thought something was going to pop up.
We use this trunk to store trinkets and papers, but I can't help thinking there's something of importance inside.
Maybe there is. Just try opening
it. It's too painful. I want to, but not yet.
Whatever you say. What if I clicked on it again?
We found this trunk at a flea market. We used to love rummaging around those in our early years.
What's up here?
Big enough for a lifetime of mementos.
I can't escape. Oh gosh, I'm scared.
We hated guns, so we never had any, even out here. But this would have been a good place to keep one, since it can be locked. We found this trunk at a flea
market. Okay, I get you.
We used to love rummaging around those in our early years.
Here we go, okay. What's this? Come love with peace in your heart, said Niam of the ice blue eyes. Ride with me, shed your mortal guise. Here is our mount, a snow white mare. Come, Oisin, to my gardens fair. In the Lord of Youth's ply, your hour shall be the Isle of Days. Out suns and sky and rainbows and our suns and sky and rainbow ways.
Come, love, with peace in your heart.
Oh, I already read that.
Said Niav of the ice blue eyes. Blue eyes.
Oh. Maybe she has blue eyes. What was that? And you just stopped doing that. What's this?
I better stay in case Serena comes back.
But isn't she dead? True friends stand by each other through any adversity. Well, that's true. I denied that so many times. What do I do now?
Perhaps in her dresser.
Oh.
Or something that she liked.
Okay. Thank you for the response. Let's see. Her dresser. No, I'm scared.
We all have our skeletons in the closet, but not Serena. She was perfect. I'm not sure why, but I don't feel like opening it. The sole thought of it drains what little energy I have left in me. Maybe later. There's nothing of interest inside the closet anyway.
But you just said... Okay. Let's look through here again.
She always thought our relationship was a blessing. God, how I miss her. No longer the cynical asshole, I guess. Her faith came as a surprise to me. She was never prudish about sex, so I just didn't expect it. I guess people simply aren't that predictable. No, I don't want to read right now. Especially not a Bible.
Maybe I have to look through each of these items, and every time I click on it, it says a different thing.
Curiously, we never brought many plants inside the cabin. We were surrounded by so many outside. I guess we were saturated by them. At least I was. Maybe I should have let her bring some plants inside. She liked them a lot.
Why didn't you?
A plant is a plant. Beautiful to some, boring to others.
Well then, if you feel that way. Blankets. Let's close this.
2 days. 3 days tops. And bam, a brand new light bulb would burn out. Whenever her lamp didn't work, Serena would come by my side to read. A few moments later, she would lay her head down on my chest and fall asleep.
That's sweet.
The only reason this lampshade gathered less dust than the other one was that we had to keep putting new bulbs in this one.
Okay.
Sometimes we joked we needed to be so far out in the woods because that's how our sex life was. Far out. The furniture came with the cabin, but the bedclothes we brought with us. A place like this needs some luxury, but without her, there are no monsters under the bed. I guess they're all in my head.
Oh gosh, under the bed? What if I looked under the bed?
I feel too restless to sleep right now.
Of course.
Because of a wiring problem or whatever, this one always starts smelling sharply of metal after being on for a while. Considering what a strong odor of metal this one gives off when in use, I guess we were lucky never to have an accident.
Well, lucky? Oh, the rug.
She made this with her own hands. She was really good.
I haven't checked over here yet.
Look what I made, hun, in case we ever need to sweep something under the carpet. See the pattern of yellow squares? It's from this rug I remembered from my nursery. I must have been like 3 or 4, but it always stuck with me.
And no trap door under there, just more creaky floor.
Why does he keep saying things like that?
I always resisted the temptation to sweep things under there when it was my turn to tidy up.
The rug's all crooked again. Can you help me straighten it out?
And no trap door under there, just more creaky floor.
Of course.
I always resisted the
temptation
to sweep things under there when it was my turn to tidy up.
Let's go through here. I haven't gone through here.
It's a beautiful day, though there's an unnatural calm surrounding the area.
Huh. I have not checked here yet. What's in here? Nothing. Just blankets and supposedly magazines or something?
I've always loved the hazy afternoon shades of this place.
You guys need to get out more. Okay.
It's deep into summer, so there's a few hours left until it gets dark.
I don't understand this. Okay, I guess the guy is reliving memories about Serena, and I'm just looking through all the things that she used to do for her husband, supposedly. Okay, let's look through here. Okay, we've got a mirror, a comb, this old and this is very antique. Let's open it up. A note.
Dearest, how do I say any of this? I like your way with words, but if I don't write this, I don't know what I'll do. My life feels so unreal now, dreamlike, but wonderfully so. Let me try, even if clumsily. The hours I spent with you when we last met are precious to me. I was so lost such a short time ago. Everything seemed drained of color and feeling. I think we were meant to find each other, to bring meaning to our lives again, make sense of the confusion shrouding both of us. When we stepped into the crystal silence of the snowy woods, away from the chatter of the guests, all nature seemed expectant, as if holding its breath, witnessing a rare moment of something infinitely better than what life in the ordinary run of things has to offer. Do you remember how the light crust of the snow glittered in the reflected light of the country house? How the copse of trees in which we walked was haloed with a magical aura? I felt the chill of the night air, and you opened your coat and enfolded me in your arms, and we hugged tight, sharing the warmth, sharing the only thing any of us have to share on this earth when you think about it.
That was interesting. What's over here?
Oh. I miss her so much. How is it possible that I can't remember her face?
Okay, let's see. There's a watch, there's some loose change that I might steal later on. I'm just kidding. There's some clothes. Let's see what's under here. Some more clothes. These are probably his clothes. They look like pajamas and plaid shirts. A mirror. No, it's a comb. Oh, the strands of her hair.
Look around some more. I have to remember her face.
There's strands of her hair right here. She's blonde.
There's a strand of blonde hair in the comb. Yes, blonde hair like sun rays. I'm remembering. What's wrong with my memory? Did I have a stroke?
Did you? Oh, okay, that was scary.
She also had a brush, but I can't see it anywhere. Nor some of her other personal items. It's just a regular comb bought from a supermarket. New enough to still have all its teeth. She also had a brush.
Okay.
But I can't see it anywhere.
What's in here?
Some of her other personal items.
There's keys.
These keys are for the cabin and the car.
Let's just get the fuck out of here.
If the keys are here, does she have her spare? I should probably stay here in case she doesn't. Did she even have her own spare?
I don't know, dude. I don't know.
We also have a key for the outhouse, but can't be bothered to keep it anywhere other than under that rock next to the thing. No one comes here anyway.
Oh, well, that's sad. Excuse me, well, that's sad.
We did have a night prowler once who left a mark inside the outhouse, but we rarely lock it anyway. I never noticed it before, but there's some rust on the ring. I should get a new one.
Let's check this one. Oh, there's some pills. Oh gosh, my flashlight went off. Excuse me one second. No, flashlight, don't leave me. Did I waste battery? Oh gosh, I wasted battery, didn't I? There it is, okay. Sorry about that. Okay. That was gonna scare me for a minute. Okay, I'm sorry. There's pills here.
They prevent my blood pressure from skyrocketing. Doctor's orders. And Serena's.
Oh, so they both take pills.
I'm generally not fond of taking medication. I find it hard to believe ingesting a few chemicals will do me much good in the long run.
Don't forget your pill, hun. I know you'd rather not, but you know it's for the best.
Beta blockers. I have high blood pressure. I'm only supposed to take these before meals.
Just like antibiotics.
Not a big fan of them. They do tend to alleviate my headaches, though. Beta blockers. I have high blood pressure. I'm only supposed to take these before meals.
Okay. I wish I could look through these things. What are these? Anyway, if I can, okay. There's the mirror. I'm scared of looking at the mirror, guys. Okay. Here goes nothing. No, not
hers. I used it too when shaving. There's only an outhouse, and for some reason, whoever erected the rickety thing didn't think to include wall-to-wall mirrors, so this came in handy. Should I dust for fingerprints? I might if I were in a detective story.
You kind of are, actually.
The last thing I need now is to see myself in the mirror. I must look awful.
Oh, gosh. That's what I was looking in. Let's see. Can I look up to the mirror? No, I can't. Oh.
Commune Evidence, Serena's favorite perfume. I've always told Serena that she doesn't need to wear perfume. Her presence is magical enough already.
Oh, how sweet.
It smells so elegant. There's violet leaf and silk tree blossom, I think. This perfume is perfect for Serena. Why didn't I ever notice? We were happy for a long time. At least, I think we were. But as time passed, we fought about every little thing, even this.
Why do couples do that? Even marriage people. Why do you do that?
I keep looking at her things, remembering all the good and bad. Depends on how you look at it. Either a wonderful sensory stimulant, an aphrodisiac, or a subtle weapon in the mating rituals of Homo sapiens.
Okay, let's see.
We were happy for a long time, at least.
Let me look back at the picture.
But as time passed, we fought about every little thing, even this.
Let me look at the picture again. Hold on. Oh, I didn't check. Let's see.
I could tell plenty of stories about this table. To be honest, I'm surprised it's still in one piece. The dining table was well worn even when we acquired the cabin. You could tell from its appearance that it had been the centerpiece of many happy occasions, and there were many more to come. Our dining table, quite modest, but if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Okay. Oh! Okay. That's what she looks like. That scared me. The picture's somewhat complete. Oh gosh, I'm afraid of putting this picture down. That something scary might happen. What was that?
Is it my imagination or are you using even more these days?
She had a point. I am on medication for blood pressure after all.
Can I leave?
Why? I might just as well stay here. I should really stay. I'm so tired anyway. I prefer the darkness inside right now.
Then go to sleep. I'm sorry, that picture scared me.
As always, I automatically went to the window side, and she took the one by the armoire.
Oh, the clock!
Some of her scent still lingers. How long has it been, I wonder? I can't tell. And I miss her so much. That ticking, it never stops. I've wasted so much time in my life. Did I ever take a break to show her how much I truly cared?
I'm guessing not, my friend.
The clock has always been rather autonomous. No matter how many times we've wound it up, it keeps going out of sync. Actually, I think it might have gone out of sync again. No trusting this clock. I wonder what time it is. As if it mattered. The clock has always been rather... Actually, I think it might have gone out of sync.
Do you remember how the light crust of the snow glittered in the reflected light of the country house?
When did the color fade from these lampshades? That's why we liked them in the first place. There's enough light already.
Hey, hand me the water glass, will you? No, wait. Let me just reach over.
No point in wiping this dust. What would it help? I used to stack books I was currently reading in here. Sometimes there were as many as 5. What's the matter with me? I can't seem to remember even ordinary things. When was the last time we made love?
Years ago, my friend. I don't know what to do now. I'm scared to turn around. Do I just turn around? I don't know. What's that? Is there anything up here that I could look at? Oh, there's spider webs. Oh, of course there is. Okay. 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 I think things like these are scaring me. It's like nothing's happened yet. I've only just been examining things as to what the heck is going on. Sorry, man. Okay.
Maybe if I go to sleep, I will wake up and there she'll be, arms wrapped around me, the warm and passionate touch of her lips. But I can't sleep. It feels as if I've been awake for ages. I don't sleep well without Serena next to me. Both a blessing and a curse, I suppose. There are no monsters under the bed. I guess they're all in my head.
What if they're...
I feel too restless to sleep right now.
Oh, let me check the kitchen again. Let me go over here. There's books here. Wait, there... What was that? What does that mean? Okay, hold on. I'm scared.
We did have a horrible fight. I just can't recall the reason.
Over what?
Is there anything worse than beautiful memories turning to dust?
Your life?
I feel like I don't even have the strength to lift the lid.
Is this guy lazy or depressed? I can't tell.
What once gave me so much joy now fills me with unbearable sorrow. Big enough for a lifetime of mementos.
Let's look over here. What's that? Oh, okay.
All those moments we sat at this table, laughing, smiling, or simply looking in each other's eyes. Will we have them again someday?
Why is she so sad? She looks so angry.
It's different. But that just... It can't be different. Am I going mad?
Probably.
Somehow she looks sadder than I remembered. Could I really have been so wrong about that night? My love, we don't have a lot of photos of ourselves as a couple, so this one is quite important. The guy who snapped this, our host that night, used an actual film camera. It was a different world back then. My love, we don't have a lot of photos of ourselves as a couple, so this one is quite important.
Oh gosh, let's see. Oh, there must be something under here. Hold on. Was that it? Hold on.
Without any activity, the corner feels cold and lifeless.
Alright, let's see. What else can I do here? Is this all the game is? Because I really don't understand it so far. Am I missing some stuff?
I'd give anything to see her standing here again, making coffee or sandwiches. I made my own too, of course, but it just made me happy to see.
Maybe I'm supposed to do a puzzle. Because right now I'm just looking
through. I didn't cook much for her. Always so worried about my stuff.
Why does that clock keep ticking? Let me go to the clock.
That incessant noise! I should smash this useless antique to pieces right now! It can't keep the time for 5 minutes straight. Chimes completely at random and never stops making that infernal noise. But hey, guess who thought it was so cute?
Serena.
This thing has caused me more sleepless nights than I care to remember. No wonder I'm going crazy. All of this these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship. They're all lies. I couldn't care less about this damn thing. Why torture myself trying to remember? I'm too upset to even think straight.
Of course.
I hate her so much.
Oh, wow.
All of this, these pathetic souvenirs from, I couldn't care less.
Then why does he want to remember her then? I don't get it. Okay, let's check the... Did I check here? Right? The music's already picking up. I don't understand that.
I should tear all her filthy, disease-ridden clothes apart and burn them! Everything she wore, just to lure me in. Not even these violent impulses give me the strength I need to open the armoire! What is wrong with me? Torture myself trying to remember.
Oh, I haven't checked here. There's more clothes. There's more for his clothes. His clothes, I mean. More of the clothes. I think that's it. Let me look at the picture again.
She's angry now. Part of me realizes I should be more shocked by this, but for some reason, I just feel numb, beyond it. She was lying to me and manipulating me all the time. Why did I let her do that?
Why?
I'm the one who should have been scowling. She played me like a harp and made me look like a complete idiot. I'm too upset to even think straight. I hate her so much.
Okay. Let's put the picture down, buddy. Let me see.
Sit down. We need to talk.
When did it go so wrong? This was supposed to be a... We weren't supposed to fight here.
You just don't get it, do you? You never do.
All of this...
Wonder what happened.
These pathetic souvenirs from our relationship. They're all lies. I couldn't care less about this damn thing. Why torture myself trying to remember? I'm too upset to even think straight.
Do you need to go out, my friend?
A part of me still thinks she'll forgive me and come back. But I've lost all hope now.
Oh, maybe she... Maybe they both had different... thinkings. Like, she left him, and now he's upset. But he's angry, and then she's angry. I don't get this.
Do I deserve to be forgiven? What about all the things she did, and all the things she said?
What did she do? What did she say?
Words and dreams may be enough for you, but you know what? You'll get a chance to test that soon, because I've had enough.
I hate her so much.
What did she do? What did you do? What did I do? What'd I do? I don't get this. Let's see. Is there anything else I could click? What about that window over there?
This armchair. This is where we had that talk. That damn...
I've been trying so hard, but we lost something along the way. Did you get my letter?
What letter?
Will you just listen to me for once? God, you're always... Wait, where are you going? Don't walk away from me.
All of this, these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, they're all lies. I couldn't care less about this damn thing.
I get this, but...
It's like looking into my own soul right now. Did I see shadows move?
Where?
No. Just my imagination. It's like the whole world is against me. Even my mind is playing tricks on me. Why torture myself trying to remember?
I'm so confused, but I'm scared at the same time. Oh. What is this? No, I thought it was that. Let's see, maybe I'm forgetting stuff here.
Changeable man, insolent wretch. Sounds like Serena, all right. Her father's realm. She was a daughter of the Celtic sea god, Mananon... What was it? Makler? Scholars say Niav's divine father, Mananon, was of an elder race even more ancient than the Tuahaja Danann.
Tuahajadana.
I'm too upset to even think straight.
What? I want you to open this box, this chest. What is it? Oh, gosh! Oh. You opened the chest. What's in here?
The jewelry box. What is it doing here? It's just a bunch of schmaltzy junk.
I sit here on the train, taking me to my final farewell to the ones who brought me to this world. I see the smiling couples on their way to new adventures and think, that used to be us. We had joy and laughter and friends once, but a memory is not the thing itself. You're very good at letting things you don't want to face slip off you. You continue as if nothing has changed, lost in your own lifeless world. Words and dreams may be enough for you. You know what? You'll get a chance to test that soon. I question how I once saw things. How much of what I thought we had were my own feelings, and how much of your manipulation? Because you are so very good with words, aren't you? You knew how to use them when we met, and for the longest time, I went along with the romantic whirl you conjured up around our shabby, isolated existence. Oh, it took me long enough to see it for what it was. And there were these moments that you swept me off on foolish flights of fancy, when I threw myself into your fantasies. You wove your spell, plying me with your magic and with wine in equal measure, and I was taken in like the lost little girl I was. Do you realize all the pain you've caused me? They say if you have to ask whether someone loves you, you already know the answer. Protestations to the contrary can no more convince me anymore than I can make my own mother or father draw breath again. Your aloofness tells a different story.
A shrine to naivety. I don't see anything else of value.
Okay. Now I'm terrified.
I should just destroy this useless junk. But not even the venom inside me gives me strength.
Do it! Just do it! Don't know what the heck is going on right now. The girl left him. The guy supposedly wants to see her again. But then he doesn't. And then she just left. But she left these notes. So what?
I hate her so much.
Of course you do. I don't understand. What else is in
all
here?
This, I couldn't care less about this damn thing.
Okay. Now I'm afraid of leaving this place. Oh, God. Let me look back at the picture again.
Why torture myself trying to remember? I'm too upset to even think straight.
The pills. Can I just end my life or just get the heck out of here?
I hate her so much.
Okay, I'm scared now. What was that? The pills. Can I do something about the pills?
I tried to flush these a long time ago, but someone noticed. As if she cared about my impotent life. High blood pressure? What a load of bull. I've never felt better in my life.
I'm sick and tired of having to pamper you like a baby. Fine, I hope you have a great, lonely time at the hospital.
All of this... these... pathetic souvenirs from our relationship? They're all lies. I couldn't care less.
I'm tired of this thing. What the heck is going on?
Where are you going? Oh, that's rich. Just run away.
I just needed to blow off steam to be somewhere else, just for a while. But I can't even remember what we argued about. Unless she was the one who left.
That's what I'm saying!
Why torture myself trying to remember?
Oh, okay, he's repeating himself. Maybe I did figure out some stuff.
How could I have been so blind? Her vanity. Always fixing her hair before bed. Doting on her hair like a child. But I'm being unfair. Would I have wanted her to be some frump? Bah, I'm too angry to even care. All she cared about was herself all along. Her needs. Her feelings. That's all that ever mattered to her. What about mine?
What about you? You sound like a pretentious douche.
Too upset to even think straight.
Okay.
Dearest, how do I-
No, I already read that. This is his watch. Let's see. Okay, is there anything else I can click on? Wish I can click on the mirror to see myself. Apparently I can't. Huh. Let's see.
Sunlight. Birdsong. Nothing feels worse when there's no hope. No chance of anything. The light is so dim here. Makes me want to chop down every tree outside.
We'll chop down every tree.
There's only a limited window of opportunity for everything. And I wasted mine. I hate her so much.
Hmm.
It feels darker by the minute, but the sun is still high in the sky. Or is it? I feel so turned around. It can't be happening. No. I can still see, even if the light is going. I'm not turning it on. All of this... these...
Okay.
Why must I always be the one to fill the damn pitcher?
When did the place get so out of hand? I hate dust, and so did she, but here's a whole freaking cake of it! If I kicked the nightstand, the dust would billow up and swallow me like a desert storm!
Well, then let's get the fuck out of here.
I care less about this damn thing.
Let's see. What's in here? There's nothing in here.
The stains on this bed suddenly make me mad. Angry, even. Why must life always end up so sordid and hateful? I'm not crawling in there. I'm too riled up for that, and it's just not dark enough anyway. Why torture myself trying to remember? I'm too upset to even think straight.
Of course you are. Why are you so upset? Okay, we already looked through all of this, and he's so damn upset about it. Let me try the other lamp.
How could I be so inconsiderate? Did this stupid lamp destroy my marriage?
Why is it? That is stupid.
I will fix it. In case she comes back.
What if she doesn't?
I haven't got any bulbs on me, and I didn't bring any tools. Wait, what am I thinking? Why am I worrying about a stupid lamp?
No, because it's bothering you.
I hate her so much.
Shake the Bible.
It's... just a book. What good will reading a fairy tale do me?
Okay, that's messed up. First of all, it's God. It's a Bible, okay? Fairy tales, it's not a fairy tale. It's a religious thing.
God has never been there for me when I needed comfort. Why would he want to go out of his mysterious ways to help me now?
Oh, but because you're a very pretentious douche.
All of this stupid, feeble-minded woman with her silly, menial things.
Hey! These silly menial things mean something to this lady, okay?
It was she who didn't deserve me. I wouldn't waste my intellect on this sublunary distraction. She probably cared more for this plant than she cared for me.
Why would you think that?
I couldn't care less about this damn thing.
Maybe if I keep talking about these things, he's just repeating himself. What's this?
Why torture myself trying okay. to remember?
Okay, let's see. I already tortured myself doing that. What about the table?
I'm too upset to even think straight.
Of course you are. Let me check the...
I hate her so much.
Okay.
All of this...
Okay. The books.
Pathetic souvenirs from our relationship. I want to hurl the whole damn lot into the lake. Or just tear at the pages until the wind sweeps them away. Some of these started to mildew long ago. Nothing gold can stay. Frost. Oh, those words. Those damn words. My whole life's been consumed by them. Now I have none left to say. I couldn't care less about this damn thing. Why torture myself trying to remember? I'm too upset to even think straight.
Okay.
I tried to be charitable with her, but what did it get me? Honestly, she could rarely carry a tune, so her humming habit got on my nerves. She actually threw this at me once.
Really?
She could have killed me. That's how the bedroom window got that crack.
bedroom window?
My wife has no indulgence given except what comes to her from heaven. We eat little, we drink less. This earth breeds not our happiness. William Blake.
Inspirational.
Never those dry, blackened omelets again. Good riddance.
Here's your stupid omelet.
Heavy damn thing. Cast iron. I hate her so much. All of this, these pathetic souvenirs from our relation. I couldn't care less about this damn. I feel like throwing this chair through the window. But that would just make me even angrier. Her favorite chair, huh? I should just smash this thing to pieces. It's wobbly and off balance, just like she was. Especially that night.
What night?
Why torture myself trying to remember?
Let me see the picture. Wait, this thing.
Yes, go ahead and empty the whole salt shaker on your meal. I hope you choke.
She was always yammering about the salt, feigning concern about my blood pressure. Should have emptied this into her lying throat till she vomited.
Wow.
If she were here, I'd rub salt into her wounds, all right, just like she's rubbed salt into mine.
Really?
I'm too upset to even think. Truth is, I could have used this spice to get some of her abominations down my throat. She never had any sense for balancing a meal. It was either spicy hot or cringeworthy bland. I was used to much better fare before my family fell on hard times. Almost empty. So typical of you, Serena. Not one limit. I hate her so much. All of this, these pathetic souvenirs.
Oh, jewelry box.
They're all lies.
What is this? Hold on. Okay.
I couldn't care less about this damn
What
thing.
Is this? Oh, I'm scared. Oh, shit. That scared me. Okay, I'm sorry. Look, there's a ring, and there's something in here. It's a ring.
Her wedding ring or mine? But what is it doing here? Oh, please, no. It's hers. I can't believe she would just leave it here. Where the hell is she?
Oh, God, my flashlight went out.
No. It can't be true.
She left you, man. Sorry about the flashlight. She left you, man.
I remember how happy these made her. She smiled.
What are those?
That wonderful smile. No. No, I didn't do it. I need to wake up from this nightmare. Why torture myself? I must have gifted these to make amends or something. Or did I? Did I ever gift her anything?
I don't even know.
She loved her trinkets more than she loved me. Right?
That's what you said with the plants. I'm
too upset to even think straight.
Let's get out of here.
I hate her so much.
What else do I have to
All
do?
Of this... These...
Oh, the carpet.
All the real color faded from it long ago. It must be full of dust mites. I should burn it. I told her the rug was fine work, like I know anything about handicrafts. But it's what the Empress wanted to hear, wasn't it? I couldn't care less about this damn thing. Why torture myself trying to remember?
Oh my gosh, this guy's just repeating himself over and over. I think I covered everything.
I'm too upset to even think straight.
What do I do now?
I hate her so
much. Let me
much.
Get the keys. I'm just gonna leave. Can I just leave?
All of this... These... pathetic souvenirs from our relationship. They're all lies. I couldn't care less about this damn thing.
I don't know what to do now. I've already looked through everything here. Or did I? Nothing seems to...
Why torture myself trying to remember?
I feel like I am missing something. Let me look at the picture again.
Too upset to even think straight.
Oh. Yeah, at this point I have no idea what to do.
I hate her so much.
Why can't I go through here? I don't understand. Oh, the stains on the floor.
All of these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, they're all lies.
I don't get this.
I couldn't care less about this damn thing.
Okay, now he's just hating everything now. I don't understand.
Why torture myself trying to remember? I'm too upset to even think straight.
I sit here on the train.
No, I did this already. What am I supposed to do now?
I hate her so much. All of these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, they're all lies.
I feel like I'm supposed to do something now. Oh, let me check the closet. The closet. Okay. Oh gosh. Oh my God. Oh my God. What the heck is that? Oh my God.
My God. What is this?
Oh God, I'm scared.
It isn't.
No.
How did it happen? I can't remember.
No, this thing's gonna jump up, is it?
It's already rotten beyond recognition. But how much time has passed? It's dry and withered. A body takes at least weeks to... How long has it been?
No, I don't know. I don't want to know. I'm scared.
I can't even remember how I did it. Maybe I didn't. Do I have brain damage? Honestly, I wouldn't be surprised.
Oh my God. I'm scared. What do I do? What do I do? What do I do? Do I leave? Can I get out of here? Oh God. What the fuck was that? Oh God, can I just leave?
Those noises sound like more than one person. Who can it be? Are they coming for me? I deserve it, but I want to see who it is first. There's something about those voices. I must know. The window.
Oh God.
The sun is a silent death for some. Dehydration, delirium. If I smash the window, I could just slit my wrists with the shards. Bashing my head through might cut a carotid artery, even quicker than the wrists.
I'm hearing voices. Also, the room's getting, like, grayscaled. Oh my God. I'm scared now. Can I just get the keys?
She's not coming back. She never left. I've been running from a lot, but I can't run away from this. I must be in shock. It still hasn't sunk in emotionally what I must have done. What else would explain it? What's happening to me?
Oh my gosh, the things are different now.
Real or some kind of drug-fueled nightmare. Wish I could overdose myself with this. Nah, an easy way out is never the best one. My head is pounding. Is it the pills I never took? Is this my punishment?
See, like, I'm touching, I'm looking at things, and...
I can't bear looking at this.
And it's, and he's saying different things now.
When was the last time she brushed her hair? Did I brush her hair? They say hair is just dead cells, anyway. The more hair you have, the more strands of dead cells sprouting from your scalp, streaming behind you in your wake. I didn't look enough at her. And now, it's too late. Her purple dress, like it was torn out of the night sky. And I tore her life from her.
Dearest.
No, I read that. Okay. Oh, the perfume. Wait, the perfume.
It smells sour and musty. Like decay.
I'm getting goosebumps and it's getting cold. Oh my gosh.
Evidence. Shit. Evidence. I can't run from this. I didn't deserve her. Whatever happens to me, I will deserve it. Isn't time supposed to heal all wounds?
Oh gosh, the clock stopped.
I've really gone insane this time, haven't I? I could swear time is standing still.
It stopped.
How long must I suffer? Would death be guaranteed? If I'm too much of a coward to try killing myself with this. No light. Only darkness, dust. Only dust.
Okay.
Will I see another dawn after this long night?
This guy's becoming suicidal. Did he kill Serena? Is that Serena? Because I really don't know.
I'd do anything to forget. To be able to focus on something. Just read again. Anything other than... Dear God.
What did you do?
Please, let me wake up. Let it be a dream. In that sleep of death, what dreams may come. I can't bring myself to close my eyes. I know I'll see her. What have I done?
What did you do?
I remember stumbling on this more than once, but she always insisted it be kept here. She did it on purpose. This rug.
I am getting chills.
Wrap the body in it. No, I can't. I can't even think about this. It's grotesque. Red like blood. Yellow like...
Dead eyes.
Dead eyes.
Oh, shit.
It might as well be a coffin. Everything within it is just dead. I should bury my sorry self in it. All those memories. I'm so sorry.
Oh gosh,
Serena.
He did kill her, Serena.
I loved you.
What am I doing? I'm just going.
With a twist of wind, O'Sheen fell hard on his homeland ground. You and me both, my warrior poet. You and me both. I read somewhere, I forget where, only one way a fairy romance can end. There's only one way anything can end, really.
Oh my god! That scared me, there's people out there. Oh! There's people out there. Let's see.
Do you realize how stupid this was? We had a plan. I took measures to ensure nothing like this would happen. But no, you couldn't help your damn self. We can't risk moving it now. The bulldozers are coming any minute.
Fire will do it.
Do you think they will buy it after all this time? It's been months since you...
Don't worry. It's all covered. He spent much time here.
Fine. Give me the kerosene.
What the fuck?
Oh, shit. We forgot your... Fuck! It was so stupid to leave it. Why did you do that?
Can you calm down? I couldn't bear to wear it any longer. It's in a safe place. We'll pick it from the ash.
Is that fire? Oh my god.
Not like this. Please.
No. Oh god, oh god. I need to get out.
No.
Oh my god.
Please. Let me go.
The house burnt down. Holy crap. Wow. Oh, okay. I need to rethink things. But that was Serena, I guess. Oh my god. I still am getting chills. That wasn't scary. It was pretty interesting. Wow. Okay. So he wasn't real. Or was he? I don't know, because outside the window it was... How did I not see that? Oh my goodness. Okay. Well, anyways, I hope you cadets enjoyed this rather long Let's Play of Serena. Leave me in the comments predicting what you think this game is actually about, because I just went along with whatever the heck this guy was going through. But I'm guessing this guy went through some depression, so... Oh. This game is dedicated to our dear friend Serena Nelson, who graciously allowed us to use her name and likeness. Oh. Oh, okay, well. I don't have words for this, but anyways. Thank you, cadets, so much for watching. And I just don't know what to say now. But I hope you enjoyed this. Because now this guy won't ever suffer ever again. So... Again, this is General Lombax Soldier, signing off.